Hello, I'm Carol May Whittick, and thank you for tuning into another episode of Higher Energetic Resonance Inspirations. This week, the topic is denial, evading reality. Denial is increasingly apparent in our society, particularly as the severe consequences of people's recent medical decisions are getting harder to ignore. At this point, the elephant is overcrowding the room, and yet, the more obvious it becomes, the deeper those in denial dig in. So this week I'm asking, firstly, what is denial? Does it serve a purpose? What happens if someone remains in this state for too long? And how can those in denial move forward? And how can we help them? A quote from Quintus Curtius: "It is of no use to pretend that something is not what it clearly is. To live in denial is to live with a suspended sentence hovering over one's head." At the end of this episode is a breathing and visualisation practice coupled with the Solfeggio frequency 396 Hz to assist with releasing guilt and fear. So let us begin. What is denial? These words I really love are from an article written by Dr. Barbara Ford Shabazz. Denial is the cornerstone of an alternative reality and is reinforced by the building blocks of motivated reasoning, rationalization, cognitive dissonance, groupthink, and confirmation bias. So denial is a defense mechanism, and it allows someone to avoid a potentially distressing truth. It's a form of avoidance, so it shows us that this person is doing all that they can do not to deal with a given situation. And denial in itself has its positives because it gives the mind some time to unconsciously process the distressful information without going into shock. It puts some distance away from actually entering into the truth. And if we imagine that we are mostly governed by our unconscious patterns and its default is to do whatever it deems to keep us safe, so holding us back from going into the truth may seem and is essentially delaying the inevitable. But at that moment in time, there's a part of us that thinks we're not able to handle what that means and taking on what that means. So we'll just stay here and we'll, as best as we can, pretend we don't see it, pretend it isn't happening. From John Hart: "Denial was a weapon. It killed truth, numbed the mind, and I was a junkie." And from Melody Beatty, author from The Language of Letting Go: "Denial can be confusing because it resembles sleeping. We're not really aware of what we're doing until we're done doing it. Forcing ourselves or anyone else to face the truth usually doesn't help. We won't face the facts until we're ready. Neither, it seems, will anyone else. We may admit to the truth for a moment, but we won't let ourselves know what we know until we feel safe, secure, and prepared enough to deal and cope with it." So at this point in time, I think we can really all recognise the level of denial in society is at a peak and probably will actually ramp itself up furthermore throughout this year. The question is, why are we seeing it? And for those who are paying attention, we can see that there is a growing number of adverse reactions and excess deaths worldwide. And yet the subject is barely discussed in the mainstream and even within private circles. So nobody dares to directly confront that there would appear to be a correlation with the jab mandates and the increase in adverse reactions and excess deaths. So if we think about where we were a couple of years ago, those who chose to abstain from the jab were ridiculed, they were vilified, they lost their livelihoods, many people had their reputations tarnished, but they stood their ground because they knew that there was an issue somewhere. Either that was through gut instinct that was then confirmed through research, or others just went directly through the research. We just felt something was wrong. Why was this being rushed? Especially when you looked out into the world instead of just focusing on what the media and in particular television was telling you of all of this death that was happening. And yet among us, it was very rare to have anybody that we knew. Or in my instance, it was very rare to meet anyone that I knew that had this so-called virus. And it's interesting also, a quick aside, is that the people who knew someone knew lots of people. The people who didn't know anybody didn't really know anybody at all. It's an interesting correlation, something that I'm still digging into to try and find out what that could mean. So the mainstream narrative continually convinced the majority who were watching that these jabs were safe and effective, and therefore also they were instrumental in driving the division between those who took it and those who refused. And those who partook in the experiment then were very loud about the fact that they did it. They took to social media to show pictures of them receiving their jabs or to vent their disgust at those who would not. And then going even further, they were convinced that the reason that this pandemic continued is because the people who chose not to do it. The level of brainwashing that went into this is beyond belief. It brought out either something that was latent in people or made them act in ways that were unnatural, we never saw. Maybe they just hid that part of themselves really well. I remember seeing somebody that I know who, I know them as a very private and reserved person, all over social media, posting numerous pictures of them in the process of receiving it. And I was just so shocked that, I mean, anytime you see anything like that was shocking. It was so completely against character for them to act in that way. So now here we are a couple of years later and the true effects are coming to light. What's interesting now that those who were so public and those who were so vocal are now very, very silent. So how does denial apply in this instance? And I believe it's protecting the fragile psyches of those who were mind manipulated to participate. And although not everyone fully realizes that they were manipulated into things, a lot of the time it takes an adverse reaction or a death in their close circle to connect the dots. And then I say that, then still that's not happening in every instance. People can be surrounded by multiple deaths and multiple instances of illness that came out of seemingly nowhere and still not be able to put things together. Or maybe they don't want to, and this is what I'm still investigating. I'm still really digging into what is happening there, because I believe we all have a level of common sense. In order to think, why is this happening when it's never happened before? What has changed? What was new that would potentially or possibly allow something to happen? It was fear that drove people who took part to do it. And now that fear has plunged them into denial. Because if they were to face the truth, they would have to admit to some major, major errors on their part, and these are in themselves all kind of life-shattering and very hard on pride and ego. To first admit that you were lied to, then realize that you believed the government and the media over your own friends and family who were incessantly trying to alert you to something that they were seeing. And you push them aside for an external force. And then realizing that this external force, these external corporations, government, pharmaceutical industry, media, the tech industry, are actually not there for your best interest at all. If your destruction makes that profit viable for them, then that's the direction that they will go. also to then face up to the fact that you have, or the people who've taken part in this, have significantly damaged their health, shortened their lifespan, and if they took their children, their young children, who were not in the position to make a decision for themselves, have damaged their children's health and potentially their fertility. And as we all know, that making any admission of guilt and apologizing for any kind of wrongdoing takes a lot of strength. It takes a strong mind, it takes a strong character. And the people who were easily coerced into doing things against their better judgment were in fear, they weren't in a strong position, and potentially they are not the strongest of people. Not being able in any instance, and I'm bringing myself into this, is when we're not able to face up to the mistakes that we make, it shows a weakness in an area of our character. For the people who've made such a colossal error, in particular, if they were very publicly disparaging against those who chose not to, it's then to kind of really their ego, their pride are at stake, and all of those things that they stood behind, all of that righteousness that they stood behind, is about to crumble. So being in that state of denial will at least protect them for the time being. Denial is fear. Denial is fear of moving forward, stepping into facing what we are confronted with. Society is perpetually kept in a state of fear. That's how it's easy for us to be controlled. And also people in positions of authority that use fear is because they ultimately realize they don't have power. And this denial is just allowing this lie to continue on both sides, because it's this gaslighting of, no, it's not happening. No, it can't be that. It couldn't possibly be. It's another iteration of the initial virus. When if we look back, we can see that the danger of us being harmed by this supposed virus was never at that high rate. In fact, if we can still find it, if it hasn't been completely scrubbed from the internet, the survival rate was up in the high 90%. It's all, you know, can you get any better than that? From Gloria Excelsior, from The Light of Reason, denial is like a cloud that obscures the sky. It blocks the truth. It reduces clarity. From Dee Brown, Breaking Passive-Aggressive Cycles, if you were a person who simply could not believe that people could be so devious, conniving or manipulative, then denial is a tactic the enemy used to keep you in darkness with a passive-aggressive person. And it's also interesting to bring up that denial is the first stage of grief. And some of the symptoms of that include feeling of numbness, feeling of confusion, shutting down, being easily distracted, acting that we're fine, turning to substances like alcohol or drugs to avoid facing the reality. And are we noticing that about us? In particular, when it comes to distraction, the media just keeps pushing narrative after narrative, useless story after useless story, in order to keep people's eyes off what's really happening and involved emotionally in a pantomime or soap opera that bears no importance on our lives on a day-to-day basis. If someone is going to stay in denial long term, it can be unhealthy. Imagine all the energetic shields and the mental shields that they're having to put up to keep ignoring what is blatantly happening in front of them. It's just easier, even though it's a journey of transformation through, to just move through the truth, to feel the pain of the reality of that truth. If denial persists, it can prevent a person from taking action to deal with his or her problems, and they just remain stuck. And the more that we stay stuck and rooted in a position, is growth is our natural state, change is our natural state. So we're going to eventually experience some sort of emotional breakdown. From Judith Sills, The Comfort Trap. Denial is the door she slams in her own face, trapping her in this lonely comfort zone. It keeps her from facing what hurts. So how to get through denial? If you notice that you are in denial or someone you trust points it out to you, there's always ways that you can work through it. And first, identify what you may be afraid to look at. Ask yourself what can happen if you keep living in denial. And to keep it current and based on the issue that inspired this episode for me, if you did actually take part and get jabbed, then maybe delaying facing up to what has happened to you may actually be detrimental. There may be something that you can do to actually start to rid your body of whatever toxin, whatever is really happening. There are many experts out there who are looking into what can be done. Can these toxins be removed from the human body? What can we do to help ourselves, to get ourselves back to wellness on a physical and biological level? Also, shutting off mainstream media. They were the ones that led you into this deception. Why are they going to change? And although I do recognise and see that there is a level of disclosure happening, it's happening on such a slow turn that I'm just wondering what the purpose of it is to move so slowly. So shut down the mainstream. Or if you must look at it, balance it with other things. And that's not just to say that the alternative is the 100% truth. There's a lot of mis- and disinformation agents working within that as well. So it's a matter of kind of balancing what you're seeing. What is the mainstream telling you that's happening? Who are they telling you that you shouldn't listen to? And why should they tell you that you shouldn't listen to that? Use your own discernment. Look at that. All the people that they tell you shouldn't look at, go and have a look at, see what they're saying, and then step back from it all and see how it lands with you. And how can we help others out of denial? Listening and recognizing that we're dealing with someone who is very scared of the truth and what it means for their life. It's like everything that they have built up as a reality is about to come crashing down. And they can feel that they're about to lose everything. And in a way, they are losing everything. They're losing living in the lie. Bear in mind that the denier will sometimes project onto you by masking their fears and trying to shame you, call you a liar, call you negative, try to intellectualize what they're seeing as opposed to what you're seeing, calling it everything else than what it is. And it's just because you've got someone who is scared and they're not ready at that point to move forward. And realize that ultimately we can't pull them out of that stage. All that we can do is just highlight to them, show them that we're available to help them as and when they need. These are people who are lacking in self-confidence as part of themselves that feels that they just don't have the strength to deal with what is facing them at their moment. Their entire worldview has shifted and they will be lost. So compassion, love, and probably the trickiest of all is forgiveness. And yes, they were mean to us. We have to remember we were trying to help them and they were in a bubble of fear and being manipulated in that fear. Until we face the truth and stop living in denial, we will never be free inside. If we are not free inside, we will not be free on the outside. From Pastor Tony Mavrikas. And to close, from Voltaire, cherish those who seek the truth, but beware of those who find it. Thank you very much for joining me on another episode of Her Inspirations, Higher Energetic Resonance Inspirations, and the Exploration of Denial. This is one that I feel is just simply going to grow, and it's probably one of the biggest challenges that we're all going to face going forward is to witness the escalation of pain that we're all going to realise by witnessing what people are going through when they really take on board what is happening in the world and how that affects them and what that means and what they've done. It's never comfortable to watch people suffer. In ourselves, we will be suffering as well because we're seeing people hurt, and this is a situation that is going to be the making or the breaking of us. And I believe it will be the former, but it will take monumental, monumental strength from all of us. But I believe we can do it. It's just a matter of us really being rooted in ourselves, really digging into whatever practices we have in order to stay strong and connected to something that is greater than ourselves, and knowing that we have the assistance should we call upon it. If you want to reach out to me, send me an email at info@carolmaywhittick.com or visit my website, carolmaywhittick.com, carolmaewhittick.com. On Facebook, carolmaywhittick.com. On Instagram, Kazmik, CAZMICK. And her conversations and inspirations on Telegram. Until the next episode, please take care of yourself. Thank you. There are times in our life when we feel stuck. Stuck in fear. Stuck because we know there's something that we need to address. And yet, although we realise moving forward and addressing this will get us to a greater place, we also know that there will be a period of discomfort as we learn and grow and transform. We always have to believe that anything that comes to us in our life is for our betterment. And standing still is only delaying the inevitable that we have to face. So with this practice, I just want to guide you to a place of calm, to release the tension and worries that you might be feeling in this moment, and then also to gently affirm with you that you have got what it takes. Wherever you are, take a seat or lie down. And I'll guide you through this breathing practice initially. This is very simple. It's just a matter of inhaling and exhaling. Inhaling for 4 beats, exhaling for 8. And as we exhale, just want to purse your lips as if you were blowing through a straw. Inhale, 2, 3, 4. Exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Inhale, 2, 3, 4. Exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Inhale, 2, 3, 4. Exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Inhale, 2, 3, 4. Exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Inhale, 2, 3, 4. Exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Inhale, 2, 3, 4. Exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Inhale, 2, 3, 4. Exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Inhale, 2, 3, 4. Exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Inhale, 2, 3, 4. Exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Inhale, 2, 3, 4. Exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Inhale, 2, 3, 4. Exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Inhale, 2, 3, 4. Exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Inhale, 2, 3, 4. Exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Inhale, 2, 3, 4. Exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Inhale, 2, 3, 4. Exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now relax. And now just feel into your body. Know that you're able to dissipate any tension, anxiety, any fear with this simple practice. Come back to it anytime you need. And as you feel how easy it is to relieve yourself of those anxieties, that feeling of stress and tension in your body, let's just affirm to ourselves, in this moment, I am safe. In this moment, I am safe. There is nothing to fear in the truth. there is nothing to fear in the truth. In this moment, I am safe. In this moment, I am safe. There is nothing to fear in the truth. There is nothing to fear in the truth.